I just fell to the floor and said, it couldn't be my firstborn son.
Mary Todd, and the moment she was told her son Shane was found hanging in his Singapore apartment. That call came last June, the 24th, from Shane's girlfriend in Singapore. Grieving, in shock, the Todds went to Singapore to bring their son's body back and hopefully find answers. Suicide was hard to accept. Their first meeting with Singapore police made it harder.
They sat there and read like a novel. Detective Call said, I am going to tell you how your son hung himself.
To the parents, the detective's explanation defied logic.
It included bolts in the wall, screwed into his wall, ropes, pulleys slung around a toilet and over a door.
Then came the suicide note. One memory in particular about Shirley Temples never happened.
Was that a big family memory? Did you ever drink Shirley Temples at the beach?
No, never. Not once. Ever did we drink Shirley Temples.
What was doubt about suicide became disbelief.
My son might have killed himself, but he did not write this note.
The Todds went to Shane's apartment. Mary Todd made a beeline for the bathroom.
There were no pulleys, there were no ropes.
There were also no screws or holes in the ceramic walls. CNN's Liz Nieslos in Singapore went to the building. Nothing the Todds saw suggested suicide.
They saw signs of someone ready to move. Clean clothes folded, boxes packed, and a plane ticket lying on the dining room table. All signs that their son was eager to move back to the U.S.
He had already lined up a new job. Shane Todd, 31 years old, had a PhD in electrical engineering and, by all accounts, a very bright future. His project involved creating faster, more powerful semiconductors using the compound gallium nitride. His parents say that in his last few months, he was stressed, even expressing fear for his life. He had told them he didn't feel right about his work, that it might be illegal, even a risk to U.S. national security. With little faith in the Singapore police and the FBI unable to help in a foreign country, the Todds had little choice but to launch their own investigation. Rick Todd had pictures of Shane's body taken when it returned to the U.S. They gave them and the Singaporean coroner's report to a forensic pathologist in Missouri. His conclusion, Shane was murdered, most likely strangled by a wire. The evidence, bruises on his hands and a lump on his forehead indicating a fight. The back of Shane's neck was cut. Hanging only causes damage to the front of the neck. There were bruises on Shane's fingers and neck indicating he was trying to squeeze his hands under the wire, again, struggling to live.
It's very hard to go through the pictures, but we will go to the ends of the earth to see justice is done.
Still, the question, why? Why would anyone want to kill Shane Todd? His parents believe the answer lies in the project their son was working on and a powerful Chinese company called Huawei. The evidence from Shane's external hard drive, they believe it was accessed after his death, and whoever did that either killed their son or knows who did. The first access, 3:40 a.m. on June 23rd.
And we're talking three minutes here.
You're talking 3 minutes.
A tiny sliver of time. They believe someone, maybe even Shane under duress, knew exactly what they were looking for. The drive was accessed again at 8:38 p.m. on the 27th, the day before the parents visited Shane's apartment. Singapore police say they accessed the hard drive before handing it over to the parents. On the drive, documents about a proposal for Huawei and IME to build a powerful amplifier using gallium nitride or GaN technology, amplifiers that could be used in cell phone towers or military radar systems. Both companies insist there was no such project and deny there was or is any relationship between them. IME and Huawei say there were preliminary talks, but nothing came of them. Huawei also says it does not do military equipment or technology. For the Todd family living in the beauty of Montana, all this overwhelming. What they want now, a full and fair investigation into their son's death.
Shane was just one of those bigger-than-life people that you could not help but notice and love.
A family devastated by loss, now resolved to find the truth. Miguel Marquez, CNN, Marion, Montana.